Shawn Michaels and Captain Charisma. Michaels got a hard-earned, albeit yet another controversial victory here in Canada using Sweet Chin Music King.
Yeah. Captain Charisma, well, that wasn't really too controversial. Captain Charisma just walked into that foot, but then Shawn Michaels walked right into this spear from Edge, and Edge wasn't finished.
Edge like a man possessed as it relates to Shawn Michaels. Edge has convinced himself that Shawn Michaels has somehow screwed Edge out of being the world's champion. I'd love to know how his conversation went with Eric Bischoff earlier tonight regarding the Royal Rumble match.
Really? What did they talk about? What do you want to know?
Your guess is as good as mine.
Hopefully we'll find out somehow tonight. But let me just tell you right now that Raw and SmackDown present WWE Royal Rumble, sponsored by PlayStation 2. Royal Rumble is a joint presentation of both Raw and SmackDown and comes to you live in 2 weeks from the Save Mart Center in Fresno, California, and exclusively on pay-per-view. PlayStation 2, live in your world, play in ours.
Wow.
Uh-oh.
And making his way to the ring from Harlem, New York, weighing in at 475 pounds, Viscera.
No pun intended, this is big, isn't it?
That's exactly what I meant, 475. Might be on the light side.
There, they say travel broadens the person. Well, from the looks of him, Viscera's been all over the world. How wide is he?
That is a big, rugged man, and certainly Viscera stock will skyrocket with a victory here. Referee Jack Gold calls for the bell, and Batista, the man that physically dominated the Elimination Chamber 8 days ago. Batista locking up with a much bigger man, a man with more mass at close to 500 pounds.
Okay, hey,
Viscera back, forcing Batista back in that corner using that size advantage.
Oh,
hard shot right to the chest, and Batista retaliates with those forearms.
Look at this. You're right. Batista did physically dominate that Elimination Chamber match, but it's going to be hard to physically dominate Viscera.
Batista now going downstairs, bearing that shoulder. Batista, 6 feet six, 318 pounds. And right now he's starting to build some momentum here. And
a clubbing ball.
And down goes the biggest man on the Raw roster.
Look at Nate.
Look who's looking on, the world's champion, Triple H and the Nate. Evolution.
What do you mean looking on? They're cheering on Batista.
Looked like, well, at least Flair was.
Yeah, well.
Batista now trying to manhandle this Viscera, getting around that corner, reverse elbow. Viscera, as long as he's vertical, Viscera is as dangerous as anybody on this roster if you can't get him down.
Boy, and he pretty much got Batista down with ease there, didn't he? Oh, no, look at this.
Look out, look out.
This could be real.
Look out, the Samoan drop from the 500-pounder, and that should be all. What a huge upset here. The Samoan drop and the elbow from the 500-pounder. The cover, the three. No, it's not three.
Man, man, and that could break your ribs.
Batista still in the hunt.
Crush his sternum.
Crowd chanting for Batista, who's down to one knee.
Viscera just comes running in there like a freight train.
Another hard shot by that big ham-like hand of Viscera. And Batista fighting back. Batista fighting back with those right hands. Man, this is one man that even makes Batista look average. And Batista is extraordinary.
Look at this battle of strength. Look out!
Batista set down. Overpowered.
Buster. Did you see that?
The 500-pounder got spine buster. And Batista wins it with that power.
Unbelievable!
Here is your winner, Batista.
spine buster, a 500 pounder.
That freak is that like superhuman.
Freak of nature comes to mind. That is a scary, impressive human being.
I don't even know how you get this rope 2 inches off the ground, but look at this.
Amazing strength. Viscera got drilled with that spine buster.
The fact of Viscera's big head bouncing off that mat, it was history.
The intensity of Batista is completely off the page. It's on another level. When he turned it on offensively, he reasserted himself, just like he did in the Elimination Chamber, where he dominated and be dominated again tonight. And we are excited, ladies and gentlemen, to be here in Toronto tonight, the Air Canada Center. Little nippy outside. Man, what an impact did that Batista make? Again, showing his dominance. When he turns it on, he can't be stopped.
Well, if somebody would have told me that Batista was going to lift Viscera in the air and Batista bomb him, I would have said you're a liar, but he made a believer out of me. Wow.
Amazing. And the role this man has been on, and I would have loved to be a fly on the wall when he was talking to Eric Bischoff earlier tonight about the Royal Rumble match. But in any event, Batista was a dominator tonight.
Told that you're the greatest world champion of all time. I heard you say it 10 times. The greatest alive today. The man. Batista! Big Dave, you were awesome, man. 500 pounds, 200 pounds, it makes no difference. You're the man.
Big boy.
Not anymore, he's not. Little boy, now.
That was awesome. That was, I mean, unbelievable. Did you talk to Bischoff yet?
Yeah, I did. He
What do you want?
He offered me a spot in the Royal Rumble match for qualifying. Match for Royal Rumble next week if I won it.
He offered you a spot to try to qualify in the Royal Rumble
next week? Qualifying match, yeah. If I won it.
I don't think that's a good idea.
Why not?
Well, you know, Dave, it's just that the Royal Rumble, Evolution should have one focus. You know what I mean? And it's just we should be focused on one thing, and that's keeping the World Heavyweight Championship with Evolution. And that means taking it to Randy Orton. You know, you being in that Rumble, that's a tough match. You know, and that's the kind of opening Orton's going to look for to take advantage of and to try to steamroll this thing. You know what I mean? And man, big man, Evolution needs you. You know what I'm saying? And I don't want you to take this wrong. Just, you know what I mean? Just hear me out here. But, I mean, you just thinking about, you know, going in that Royal Rumble and stuff, it just seems a little bit selfish. You know what I mean? I mean, think about it. You know, you want to go in the Royal Rumble. Then next thing you know, you want to win the Royal Rumble. And then you want to take a shot title. And then, you know what I mean? It's all just like you. I'm not hearing like Evolution. It's just, it's like it starts being all about you. And it's just, you know, I mean, don't get me wrong. It's all self-centered stuff. You know what I mean? It just, you end up sounding kind of like Randy Orton. Now listen, don't get mad. I know you've had a tough match, okay? So you just need to, maybe you just need to sit down and take a break.
No, you're right. I got your point. I got your point. Nobody likes a selfish, self-centered egomaniac. I'll let you know what I decide.
Well, you know, JR, I'm a bit of an artist myself, and I know one when I see one. That Chris Masters truly is a masterpiece. He's a work of art.
And ladies and gentlemen, another work of art is the Royal Rumble.
Oh, yeah. And check out the official theme song of the Royal Rumble. It's Find the Real by Alter Bridge. And that's available right now, you know.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the Royal Rumble match just only happens once a year. 15 Raw superstars, 15 SmackDown superstars, for a total of 30. And the match continues until only one man remains. That man may pick his champion in the main event at WrestleMania in Fresno in less than 2 weeks. And then the World's Heavyweight Championship. Does Randy Orton have a champion's number?
Well, I'm going to tell you something. Randy Orton wants it. I've heard him tonight. We've seen him tonight. He seems to want it more than anything in the world. But Triple H wants to keep it more than anything in the world. The World Heavyweight Championship. Who's